Hi, welcome to our videos. In this video, I am going to solve a problem based on weighted average property. If you have not watched our video on weighted average, please do watch it first so that you can better understand this video. Anyway, I will recall that property briefly for solving the question here. So, let's go ahead with the question. The question is like this. In a group, the number of males is 45. In another group, the number of females is 35. So, 45 and 35 represent the number of persons in the two groups, males and females. These M&F represent the average ages of the two groups. M is the average age of the 45 males and F is the average age of the 35 females. What we have to solve in this question is find the average age of the two groups of males and females. That will be totally 80 in strength. 45 plus 35 will give you 80. So find the combined average age of the two groups of males and females and compare that combined average value with this F plus M by 2. The question is that combined average of the two groups males and females, will it be greater than F plus M by 2 or will it be equal to F plus M by 2 or will it be less than F plus M by 2? You are also given an information that F is greater than M. Okay, this is the question and the information. Let's go ahead with the solution. Now, if you recall the weighted average property, it will be like this. Combined average of two groups, also called as weighted average, as a property, weighted average will be a value. Weighted average of two groups will be a value that lies closer to the average of that group which contains more number of terms. Terms here, if you understand, will denote ages of the males and the females. Those are terms here, data. So therefore, according to the weighted average property, we should be able to say that weighted average or combined average of males and females is going to be a number, a value that lies closer to M, which is the average of the group that contains more number of terms. So from this property, we are able to say weighted average will be a number closer to M than to F. Now a number closer to M than to F will be less than the mid value F plus M by 2 if this information is given. And since this is given, so we can safely conclude that weighted average being nearer to M than to F because of the property stated will be a number less than F plus M by 2. So combined average or weighted average will be less than F plus M by 2. If this is still not completely clear, let's put some numbers for F and M and make this more concrete. Say for example, 20 for F and 10 for M we write. So 20 is greater than 10. So the average age of the 45 males is 10. Average age of the 35 females is 20. So F plus M by 2 would be 10 plus 20 by 2, 15. Now if you observe, a number such as 14 will be less than 15 because it is closer to 10 than to 20. 14 is 4 numbers only away from 10, but 6 numbers away from 20. So 14 is closer to 10 than to 20. And because of this, 14 is less than the mid value 15, mid value of 10 and 20. So by probability, we got weighted average to be closer to M than to F. So it will be less than the mid value f plus m by 2. This we can grasp more concretely by putting some values for f and m. Now suppose this information f is greater than m is not given, then what would happen to the answer? If f is greater than m is not given, if it is not given, then between f and m, if f is greater than m is not given, then between f and m, you can have three relationships. One is f is greater than m, another f is equal to m, and lastly f is less than m. Then the answer would change. The relationship of this with f plus m by 2 would change like this. If this is not given, this would be one of the possibilities for which we got that weighted average or average a could be less than f plus m by 2 when this is given. If this is not given and when we explore this possibility, say f is 20 and m is also 20, then average age of males 20, average age of females is 20, and f plus m by 2 also is 20. That means weighted average is closer to 20, which is same as 20, which is same as 20. In other words, this average age would become equal to f plus m by 2 if these two ages are same. And the case when you have f is less than m, say 10 is less than 20. If you observe this, I would have to write there, that I would have to write here. So males, females 35, males 45, 20 here, 10 here, and f plus m by 2 is 15. Now combined average, also called weighted average of the two groups, males and females, as per the property, would be a value leaning toward 20, which is now the average age of the group in males, because that is the average of the group which contains more number of terms. Now a number closer to 20 than to 10, number closer to 20 than to 10 will be greater than 15. Like for example 16, which is closer to 20 than to 10, 16 is greater than 15. From property, weighted average this time would incline toward 20 as we are exploring this case, 10 less than 20. So number closer to 20 will be greater than the mid value f plus m by 2 when we explore this possibility. That means weighted average compared to f plus m by 2 would be greater, equal or less than when this critical information is lacking. This time, since in the question this is given, we are able to say combined average by property, since it will be closer to m than to m than to f, should be therefore less than the mid value f plus m by 2. This is how we can solve questions easily by using the property of weighted average. Thank you for watching this video.